वंडरफुल,
इसका
रियली
वर्ड क्या
ग्लैड
होगा?
टू, या आई एम रियली ग्लैड टू हैव ऑल ऑफ यू हियर, एंड वी द स्टूडेंट्स एट कोटवाल स्कूल आर ऑल्सो वेरी एक्साइटेड टू शोकेस देयर डेमो मॉडल्स और द मॉडल्स दैट दे हैव डन फॉर दी फॉर टुडेज एग्जीबिशन. सो आई रिपीट, वी हैव कोटवाल क्लास 9 स्टूडेंट्स, बट the models that you are going to see as part of today's exhibition was done by the same students when they were in their previous academic year, that when they were in 8th class, that is when they learned about all these concepts in robotics, and have made these models that we are going to demo today. Right, out of many models and many technology or the concepts that they have learned, we are just showcasing only four of them because of the limited time that we have. All right, and I hope you all find them exciting, and yeah, the students are also very excited to talk about the products. So let's get started, guys. So I hope you can all see my screen, and quickly I'll show you the projects that we are going to showcase today. Okay, so the first one is, okay, one second. Okay, let's take a look at the autonomous crane model. So students who have been assigned for autonomous crane model, can you give me a brief description of the autonomous crane, please? Well, I have Miss Anusha with me. She will be helping me out with the demo.
Good morning, Anusha ma'am.
Yeah, good morning. She is out with the demo. Yeah, so autonomous crane. So the students have actually learned the mechanical assembling of robots in their previous grades. Basically, when they were in, like starting from first class till fourth class, they have learned how to design and mechanically assemble different types of robots using individual components, individual bare parts like screws, nuts, steel plates, motors, gears, all these things they have learned how to assemble it. But now, after learning the Arduino programming, they made these kind of cranes autonomous. That means if they have been assigned for a specific task, let us say they have designed a pick and place kind of a robot, so using the same mechanical structure, they are now made it intelligent so that it can work on its own. So if you can see my video, we have placed a robot on the table right in front of me, and it's a kind of a click and place robot which works autonomously. That means the moment I turn it on, its only repeated task is to actually go pick up an object from the source position, that is the starting position, and turn its body. It has the capability of lowering the arm and raising the arm, and at the same time, it can also turn its entire body right to a suitable direction, and at the same time, it can also traverse from one location to the other location. So let us say we have assigned this task of this pick and place robot to pick up some object from that starting location, raise its arm, turn the body, and then go to a destination position and drop the object there. All right. So I will let the, okay, I'll, before that, students, can you tell me what are all parts we have used in this robot? In this pick and place robot, what are all the parts we have used? The major components you can go with. Yes,
Sir,
anyone? Yeah.
Arduino UNO,
Yes.
Adafruit motor shield,
Very
and
good.
four BO motors,
Yes.
and battery we can use 9 volts or 12 volts, and crane structure means that all steel bars which are used like nuts, L plates, D plates, and that all things.
Very good. So those are the major components, or the only components. I think we have covered everything, and suitably we have also used some gears to get that entire functionality going. right? So I will now turn it on to see how it goes. So the first task is, the moment I turn it on, it will lower its arm so that we can put some object there. Again, raised its arm. Now it will turn its body using one more motor and the gears, and it goes in front. Let us say it goes to the destination, tries to lower its arm again so that we can, it can drop the object there, raise its arm, again turns back the body so that again comes back to the original position, and it again starts from the, goes back to the source. So this is a continuous task what mostly robots are meant for. So they kind of just do a task repeatedly, and that's why the name of the robot is autonomous crane, which automatically does a given task repeatedly basically. So its only job from morning to evening is pick up an object from one location and drop it in another location. So the kind of programming that the students have done here is to make this autonomous so that it can do all the tasks on its own, right? Without any human involvement, the only job is pick up an object from one place and drop it in another place. All right. Okay. So yeah, any questions regarding this product? So this is really nice. The kind of programming that the students have learned with these kind of thing, how to control those motors and what is the timing with which they have to control these motors, it's all calculated. So I really appreciate the way the students have done this project. And yeah, it's a perfect combination of mechanical assembling of robots and at the same time programming to make the robots more automatic basically. So making the robots intelligent so that they can do the task repeatedly in a programmatic way. Yeah, any questions so far? Okay.
So which language did they use to program this frame?
Sorry, come again.
Which language did they use to program it?
Yeah, we used Arduino, so Arduino programming language, which is pretty much like C language. As the student mentioned, we also have the Adafruit motor shield on top of the and the Arduino, which will control the motors basically. All right, so let's